everyone, and welcome to this week's video. Today I'm going to be explaining exhaust headers. Now, exhaust headers are basically one more step if you are working on getting a full new exhaust with a larger diameter piping throughout it. So if you haven't yet watched my video on cat-back exhausts or my video on how to increase horsepower via the exhaust, you should probably check those out first. I'll include links in the description. Now, this particular exhaust header is a Yonaka header for Acura Integra B-Series engines. And so I'm just going to be kind of going over this and how these are used to increase horsepower. So the exhaust header is the first piping after the exhaust from the engine exits through the cylinder head and starts to leave out of the car. So the purpose of a performance exhaust header is clearly to increase horsepower. Now, it does this with two main ways. First of all, it's going to have larger piping. So for example, with this Yonaka collect header, it's going to have 1 5/8 piping for the primary pipes coming out, and then it is also going to have a 2.5 inch collector. The collector is where all of the individual pipes join together and then go out to the exhaust as one throughout the rest of the system. So the other thing this does is it supports scavenging. So the longer these long tubes support exhaust scavenging. So if you've watched my video on how exhaust can be used to increase horsepower, you should be able to understand that as far as how scavenging is done in order to increase horsepower. So one of the things that's common with aftermarket exhaust headers, especially in the Honda Acura Japanese market world where we've got four-cylinder engines, is a 4-to-1 header or a 4-to-2-to-1 header. And basically all that is describing how the piping joins together and finally forms into one. So with the 4-to-1, you take all four and then they just go to one, just like the name is. With the 4-to-2-to-1, two of the pipes join together and then finally they all meet after that. So a little difference. And I looked at some dyno charts online just to kind of see some main differences here. And it doesn't look like there's a huge main difference, but the power band is shifted a little bit higher with the 4-to-1 rather than the 4-to-2-to-1. So this is a very exaggerated curve here, but basically if you have torque on one side and RPM on the other, the 4-to-2-to-1 header is going to kind of have its peak torque at a little bit lower RPM than the 4-to-1 header. And once again, at the graphs I looked at online, it didn't seem to be a huge difference, so it's not anything major like I've shown here. And then both of them seem to have a decent advantage over the stock if you did have an engine with a significant amount of power. So, of course, with these kind of things, with the larger piping, you're going to want to match it to your horsepower. So it's not necessarily, if you have a very low horsepower engine, getting a larger header may not be beneficial. And I kind of go more into this in my video on cat-backs. So that's kind of why I referenced checking that out. But Yonaka says the header that they supply is good for about 5 to 10 horsepower on the stock engines. And of course, that's more effective if you have a more powerful engine. One of the things with these pipes is the larger you create these individual pipes and the larger the collector is, you're kind of shifting where the peak torque is going to occur to a higher RPM. So larger piping, you're going to have better flow at higher RPM when you've got a lot more flow. So it'll kind of shift that torque, that peak torque, up into the higher RPMs. Some of the challenges involved with an exhaust header, especially one with longer length pipes, is the install can be kind of a little more complicated, where you may have to remove some components, move some components, and also weld the end to the catalytic converter or the rest of the exhaust that you've got going on. Also, you can run into clearance issues, especially with lowered cars, as this exhaust header may be the lowest part in your car, and so if that's the case, you want to make sure that's kind of protected or that it's not really that low for the area that you're driving in. So just taking a look at this Yonaka header, this is a stainless steel header, and you can see the 1 5/8 inch piping heading down, and that all meets up to a collector, and then at that collector you've got 2.5 inch piping, and that's the outer diameter, so the inner diameter is actually a little bit smaller. And then here is where you can install the O2 sensor. You can just place that right in there. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below, and I will include a product link in the description.